to my channel if you've been here before. I love to upcycle clothes from thrift stores and flea markets, things like that, and just make fun, edgy pieces and accessories. Today I'm going to be working on just a plain pair of Levi's, and I'm going to distress them and patch them. And this is actually the finished product. I have the word love on the back in denim, bleaching, distressing patches. This is what we're gonna make today. So stick around, I'll show you what I did to create this look. And if you find value and like these tutorials, be sure to subscribe so that you can see upcoming tutorials. The first thing I did is I put these pants on and I took a marker and I marked where my knees are. That's kind of important. Sometimes when you cut out patches or try to patch the knees, they get too high or too low. So it's always best to try them on, figure out where your knees are, and mark it with a pen or a marker. The next thing I'm going to do is, I still have my Goodwill tag on here, is I'm going to cut the sides open. I almost always do that when I do patchwork or a lot of embellishing to jeans. It's just way easier to work that way. So I go to my side seam and I cut half an inch behind that seam, not on the front side, but on the back side. And then when I get to the top, I come up half an inch. So I miss that grommet if I stay over here. And if I stay where I said, then I miss that belt loop too, and it's easier to sew back together if you stay half an inch behind that seam. Now I have my sides cut open, and what I want to do is cut both these pockets off. And I'm not going to seam rip it because I just cut them off from the inside, and I leave all this extra seaming and stuff. I like the detail of that and I like all the fraying. So I will cut both those pockets off. Now that I have my pockets cut off, what I want to do is spell out the word love on the bum here. And I'm going to use a dark denim from my stash that I thrifted. And I will cut out the letters L-O-V-E, and I want to sew them on the rear end here, and I'll show you how I do that. How I begin creating my lettering for the back, you can try to find stencils if you want, but I always just draw my own. So I take a piece of paper, and this is just packing paper, and I cut it out to basically the size I'm going to want my letters. And then I draw my letters on that. Okay, here are my letters. And basically, they're kind of like bubble letters. Remember when you were a kid and you're doodling on your notebook and you write your name in bubble letters? That's all I did here. And now it's time to cut them out. Okay, so now my letters are all cut out, and now I'm tracing them on an old pair of jeans that are a few shades darker than the ones I'm actually working on. I want to be able to see them, but I don't want them to be super, super dark or black. So I just took my letters, and I traced them on the pant leg of another pair of jeans, and now I need to cut them out. But I want to give you a little helpful tip that I learned the hard way. So if you're tracing your letters on the front of the jeans, this is the right side that you want to use, you do your letters like you normally would. But if you're tracing on the back side of your jeans, say you want to use a marker and you don't want it to show, you've got to make sure you turn your letters over. The E wouldn't matter so much. The L would probably matter. So if you're doing it on the right side of the jeans, just trace normally, but if you're doing tracing it on the back side of the jeans, flip that letter over. Now I am going to cut these out. Okay, so now I'm just about ready to pin my letters down on the rear end of these jeans, but before I did that, I added this light colored denim patch, and it's about 10 by 6, and I used a regular stitch, small enough so that it stays secure, but not so small that it takes me forever to sew around it. And then I just use gold thread because these jeans, almost all of them have gold thread, and I like to sort of stay with that. So now it's time to put the letters on. So I've started placing my letters. I want them a little bit low. I kind of like them on the rear end part of the jeans. And I will just kind of play with this. I want a little bit of a curve. So like the L will be a little lower than the O. Same with the E and the V. So I'm just going to play with this a little while until I have it exactly the way I want it. And then I will pin them down. Now my letters are all pinned in place. I will take this to my machine, and I'll take that front plate off of my machine so that I can get inside here a little better. And I will just go around the letters, work with it the best I can, and use a smaller stitch, but like I always say, not so small that it takes me forever to sew. Now I have my letters sewn on the back of my pants, and all I did here was just went around the letters. And I've decided on this side, I want to do a distressed hole. And when I do my distressed holes, I kind of figure out where I want them. And then I take a piece of chalk and I just sort of draw out where I want them to be. And I want mine to be about that big and about right there. So what I do now is, so my pant legs are still cut open on the outside. I'll stick my cutting board, a small cutting board, right where I'm going to be distressing. And I use a box cutters. This is called a slice, but any box cutters will do. They all pretty much work the same. And I will just really start distressing these. Now, these jeans have a little bit of spandex. It makes it a little more hard to distress, but I'll just dig in and go to town. If they're 100% cotton, they cut a lot easier, but I'll show you what that looks like when I'm done. My distressing is all done, and this is what it looks like. And I'm going to patch that from the inside of the jeans. So I will open that pant leg up, and I'm going to use a dark patch. I think it's the same fabric as I used for the letters up here. And I will turn this over, dark side down, and I will pin that on, and then I will do a zigzag stitch all the way around it in the gold thread. I have this patch sewn on, and that's what it looks like from the outside. And then when I wash and dry this, it'll get super frayed and cute. Now I'm going to turn my jeans over and work on the front side. And remember this mark that we made at the knees? What I'm going to do is I want to do a giant cutout rectangle patch in each knee. And so where I mark this, that'll sort of be my center. And I cut out a piece of paper, and this is about 6 by 10. And I want to lay it over that mark. And I want the mark to sort of be in the center of my rectangle here. And then I will take a piece of chalk. Let me find my chalk. And then I'm going to draw around that, trace around that rectangle. And once I get that traced, I'm going to put it on the other pant leg. I'm going to line up the bottom and try to get that in a very similar spot. And I will trace around that. Now I have my rectangles traced in chalk. I am going to go inside and I am just going to cut them out. Here's what my cutout holes look like. They're rectangles. And so now what I want to do is take that same pattern that I cut the holes out with, and I want to make, I'm using a very light colored denim, and I want to make patches for those holes. And so I'm just going to take the same pattern. It can't be the same size, of course, or you won't be able to sew it over your hole. So I'm going to go over this about half an inch, or about an inch, all around the border here. And that's what I'll cut out for my patch for the inside. Now I have my two patches cut out, and I need to sew them on. So what I will do is open these up. And there are two sides to this. One's a little lighter than the other. I'm going to put the very lightest one down over my hole. And I will go around and pin that. And I will pin it pretty tightly. I'll put quite a few pins in there because that big hole may shift a little bit if I don't. And then I will go around it with a zigzag stitch on both pant legs. Okay, so here's what the big patches look like. They're all sewn with the zigzag stitch and the gold thread. Now I want to do one more little piece of distressing and patching, and that's going to be up towards the top of the pants. And so again, I will just take a piece of chalk and just sort of draw out where I want it to be distressed. And then I will stick my cutting board under there. Take my box cutter and do the same thing to this side that I did to the hole on the back side. So now I have that all distressed, and what I will do is turn that over to the back side, and this time I'm going to use a dark piece of denim for my patch. I'm turning it over and putting the dark side down. I will pin that and zigzag stitch around it. Okay, so now I have that patch sewn on. And it is time to sew my pants back together. Remember, we cut the sides open. And I will just stitch this on the outside. I want to see that fraying down the side. And I will do, I'll try to do a quarter inch seam allowance. Sometimes these seams and stuff get a little tricky because they're thick. Up here, when you sew, throughout all this, it's best to have a denim or a jean needle. These can get a little tricky to get through, but once you get past here, it's not too bad at all. So I will go over this twice with a fairly small stitch and a quarter inch seam allowance, and I will do both sides of the pants. Okay, I'm sewing the sides together. I never pin these. I mean, you can if you want, but it's pretty easy to hold these together as you're stitching. Now my sides are all sewn back together. And the last thing I'm going to do is I'm going to go over the jeans in certain areas and just really rough them up with the box cutter. I want them to look distressed and worn. So I will start down. I like the length of these pants. A lot of times I cut the bottoms off because I'm short and they're usually too long for me. But I like the length of these, so I will just rough up the bottoms. And I'll go all the way around both pant legs like that. And I will do the rest of the jeans. I will make little slits across the waistline at the top, just kind of like I did the bottom. The belt loop in the center has a couple layers of fabric there. I can rough that up without really making a hole in it. I will go along this pocket, along the front pockets, and the belt loops in the back. And that's probably about it. I may do a little hole, like rough up a little hole, like maybe above here. I'll go in between where the pocket and the jeans are, maybe do a little hole because that pocket hides that hole. You won't see skin through. I don't know. So after I distress it with the box cutters, I'm going to wash them and dry them, and then I will show you what they look like on. Okay, I have a little update here. Before I washed them, I did a little bleach treatment on them. So I just took pure bleach, poured it in a bucket, and took a white rag, and I just wipe over the jeans. The rag is always pretty saturated, and I did that to the front and the back and let it sit for 3 or 4 minutes, and then I put it in the washer.